Okay, Face, be as quick as you can.
Don't worry, I'll be quick.
But fast as you can.
I'll be fast. Booyakasha!
What a Hello and welcome to Talk Show. This is our second episode.
Today we've got something a little bit special for you. We've pulled a few strings. Citroen have come together and given us the new Citroen C4 Cactus. Love it or hate it, it's a Marmite car. Matt, what do you think?
I kind of wanted to dislike the car immensely when I saw pictures of it, but it's growing on me.
Yeah, I drove it down here and I have to say, super impressed. Really, really, really liked it.
So which one did you drive?
I drove the 1.2, 82 horsepower petrol.
Okay.
But it also comes in 100 horsepower diesel.
But that's a three-cylinder engine, yeah?
Three-cylinder.
Okay, well, this one, the one which I'm going to drive later on, is the 1.6 diesel, 100 horsepower blue.
I'm really excited to find out more and drive the car a lot more.
Sure.
And really get
me
to
too.
Explore.
Well, I think later on, we should stop and maybe ask the public what they think of the visual looks of the car, get a bit of feedback. But it is very much a Marmite car.
Definitely.
You're either going to love it or you're going to hate it.
Definitely a Marmite car. What do you think?
But anyway,
have a look around the cars. Tell us what you think.
I quite liked it when I first saw it over
there. What do you think, young man? Do you like that car? That's all right.
Is it comfortable in there?
I'm filming you. Filming me.
I'm filming you.
I'm filming you. Filming me. You like it? Yeah? Let's take that out so you won't drive off accidentally.
This is, aren't they? And then people open their doors.
That's right.
You know, or you get the trolley dinks.
I think they're going to be starting at 12.95.
Really?
Yeah.
It's an excellent car. Very, very interesting.
Glad you like it. George, what do you think?
It's good.
So listen, let's go take these cars for a drive. Let's put them side by side. Let's see what they drive like and learn a little bit more about the cars inside as well. Let's do it. Do the serious boring bit now.
Come on then.
This really is a defining car for Citroen. The C4 Cactus is the first of their new split between the DS range and the new economical, quirky design Citroen range. And so the Cactus really brings us everything that the new C line is to encompass. It's economical, it's efficient, it's lightweight, it's simple.
What were you saying?
Citroen is all about just quirk and economy. This represents Citroen and Citroen's future.
Okay.
That's what Carlos Tavera, the new global managing director of Citroen Peugeot, says.
Nine. Mission operation. Launch approval. Launch approval. Launch approval.
One of the things we keep going on about are these air bumps. These. Very different to any other car. You can squidge them in, so if somebody opens their door, bang, it's not going to do any damage. Air bump. That's all I need to say. There's all sorts of quirky things you can have and you can spec up. These can go to white. You can choose different coloured cactus strips that go in here. No, that's your job. You love touching and feeling the rear end, especially with men. Boot space. Now, we've got loads of crap in the boots. It's a generous size. Now, one issue I noticed is these are not split folding rear seats. It goes down as one. I don't know. I don't know why they did that. Back windows. There is no mechanism for the windows to go down, but they do pop out. When you're driving down the road and you've got them open, you're not going to get that noise you do if you have
Yeah,
to.
Yeah.
Okay, inside I noticed there's only one cup holder, but at least they put a cup holder in, but there is only one.
It's good of the French to at least remember this time.
You've got these seats and they're really comfortable.
Super comfy, right?
Yeah.
They're super soft, but they hold you well. They've gone old school. It's kind of like that in the whole dash here area, isn't it? Dashboards are just a litter of buttons and stuff. They've taken out all that clutter
and
they put it all in this touchscreen system here, leaving the dash really clean.
Oh, look, they're all like staring.
So many people are looking.
Which
that guy's vomiting? Why is that guy vomiting?
Okay, so how does it drive, Matt? That's the important question.
Right, well, it drives really well. So you've been driving that 1.2 one today.
I drove the 1.2, I liked it. Okay, it's a little bit underpowered, but then when you're talking about 70 mpg, I can live with that. All of the cars are under a ton, meaning that they're just like super efficient. And so again, I know you've said it before, but zero road tax.
Yeah, no, that's incredible.
There's three different specifications, which is the touch, yep, feel, yep, and the flare.
Okay. Go for the flare, you're gonna get the sat nav, you're gonna get the hard drive, a hi-fi pack, you're gonna get these nicer wheels, you're gonna get the park assist. We are gonna go to the parking button, enter parking slot, I'm gonna indicate, and it's gonna scan a space. Okay, so sit the car in reverse, hands off steering wheel, and off we go. Just doing the throttle, and I am doing the brakes, which is pretty neat. Nice and tidily, there you go, sorts the steering out for us there. Yep, okay, cool, fantastic.
What are those black bits then?
These are like rubber things.
We're gonna pop that on the dash. Okay, ready?
Yeah.
No way!
That is awesome, that doesn't actually
move. That's cool. That is super cool. Yeah. I can't believe that.
None of the cars have got rev counters either. What you do get is you get this coming
gear
out to the right.
Gear efficiency indicator.
Yeah, they want you to change at the most economical point. Yeah. So when that
in
gear
your car, you've got a gay efficiency indicator, haven't you? To indicate how gay you are at certain times.
The steering is really light as well, and it's got a good steering lock.
Okay, let's get out.
It's not the fastest thing in the world, but you know it feels comfortable, and it was great to drive.
I think all three of us wanted to dislike a car.
As I said,
From its initial look, this is the thing. It's we said from the beginning.
Within minutes, I was actually starting to like it.
Yeah, but you certainly get to love it once you get in it, you drive it, and you appreciate what it is. It's like anything when it's new, people just want to dislike it. There was a Facebook page that I came across the other day, and they were saying some horrific things.
Haters.
Don't look at it. Yeah, real age. Literally,
yeah.
Style meeting practicality and affordability, isn't it?
That front end is wicked as well. Those LEDs that are blended into the body.
When it's following no compromise. When you were following us, it looked really quite aggressive from the front.
Yeah,
it does.
Kind of
cool.
Yeah, it doesn't look as good from the back, in my opinion, but you sort of forget about
it. It's a bit lame.
Yeah, look, they compromise a little bit.
Scores out of 5.
4.5. I think it's great value.
Okay.
Well, you'll get it.
Right, I'm going to say 4 out of 5.
Okay.
It's like a concept car that's actually being put into production.
It is. Jerry, what do you think?
Yeah. I'm going to give it a 5. Good style. Really well thought of and considered. Like, really, really well thought out. But for what and who it's aimed at, it is. It just does everything. And I really, really, really admire that. Thank you all very much, ladies and gentlemen, for taking the time to watch our second episode of Talk Show. We hope you enjoyed it. We hope you enjoyed learning a little bit more about the Citroen C4 Cactus. I know we all did. Tune in for our next episode. Please subscribe on YouTube and like us on Facebook and tweet us on Twitter. I need to finish my pint, so right,
you do what you need to do.